with my position now, I'm a principal economist with the government. I'm in a point where I assume roles or leadership roles. With this opportunity, when it presents itself, I thought I should sharpen my leadership skills. That's where I decided to join the course. The program itself is set aside a particular project that each group or student has to undertake, and that also has made me realize how deep I can impact my community with such a kind of projects in hand.
I'm the founder of a company called AKM Glitters Company Limited, dealing with integrated pottery business.
I came up with this idea and I shared it with my colleagues. So we started mobilizing our own resources to build these 5 houses in a very short time. We had no youth, so we had to collaborate with the development officer. He gave us youth. The first group was not easy. We had dropouts in the first 2 weeks. When we started training, the youth stopped dropping out. So as you can see, bringing this together, it was all about CALA training. Each youth here is being paid an allowance of 70,000 a month, and they still have a profit to generate, which will be collected for 6 months for them to continue after here.
Tanga yetu ni mradi ambao unataka kuweka jiji la Tanga kuwa rafiki kwa watoto na vijana barehe. Na halmashauri ya jiji la Tanga tuna takribani ya vijana 120,000. Lakini walionufaika na mafunzo haya ni vijana 50 tu. Kwa hiyo ni imani yetu sasa hawa vijana waliopata mafunzo 50, kwa sababu wanatoka katika kata tofauti tofauti ambazo tunakata 27 za halmashauri ya Tanga, tuna imani sasa kwamba hii elimu waliopata hapa wataenda kuifanya katika kata zao na hatimaye watu wote watakuwa na uelewa wa pamoja.
The CALA program is very rich. It's all about these analytical tools that we were using. Problem solving was the best. When we were advised to drop the first project, we had given up. And one day, I just came up, it was at night, and I was like, oh no, I cannot give up. So it was all about commitment and respecting the people who had invested in us. When we're talking about the tools, at the moment, we were able to bring in a lot of stakeholders to collaborate into developing the National Pottery Strategy. Now, I'm rethinking about scaling up this project into other regions or into other African countries, because it's doable and it's sustainable. I would not have thought about this if it was not for the CALA.
At the momentum with which we are going, the project has the capacity to succeed really well because we do not plan to stop here. Rather than selling our 4-week-old chicks, we plan to introduce a 3-month-old chicken, which I think will be very accepted here.